And why did you decide to protect your car with a recovery device?
I was nervous. I didn't want to have the same problem again. I wasn't sure that, you know, getting, first of all, I got the same car again because I did like it, and I figured there had to be something that I had to do. So I got the club, which also dissuades a little bit. But also for insurance purposes, they do require you to put something on your car. Mm-hmm. And there's Sherlock, or there's a whole bunch of things, but I don't know, I felt that Boomerang was the way to go. So
do you feel different now that you're protected with the club and with the Boomerang?
I feel better. It's a day by day thing. I won't say that every day when I get to that parking lot, there's always that fear. But again, it's a car, it's a material thing, so I try to put everything into perspective.
Of course.
But yeah, it's still there, and not to mention there was, you know, a girl that worked in the same building as me that, you know, a month after mine was stolen, she had just purchased a car 3 weeks prior, and her car was also stolen. So, and I find myself, every time I come to work, looking around to see if I notice any shady people around the area, in cars, walking around, but I mean...
So that sense of violation, that sense of trust kind of still...
Yeah.
Still hangs around.
Yeah.
What would you recommend that drivers do, or your friends even that work with you, so that they can protect their vehicles from theft?
I tell my friends all the time not to leave things in their car, not even just for the car being stolen, but also, you know, a lot of people's cars are being broken into because they figure, well, if I put my iPod into the glove compartment, it'll be safe. The reality is there's devices out there now that can detect whatever's in your car. And people will break in no matter what. So I've been telling people just be cautious that way. And
thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
My pleasure.